Hello students, welcome to class 10 ICSE Foundation Mathematics by R.S. Agrawal, Goel Brothers Publications. We are going to study about mean, which is apart from the measures of central tendency, episode 9.1. Let us begin with the topic mean. Sometimes they use the word mean or sometimes they use the word average. What is the meaning of mean? What is the meaning of an average? For a given data, a single value of the variable representing the entire data, which describes the characteristics of the data, is called an average of the data. Now, this is just a simple definition. But the thing is that unless and until you don't work it out with an example, you won't follow the meaning of an average. As for example, let us take the annual, let us take a rainfall of a particular place in a week. So, as for example, if I am taking the average rainfall of the week in a particular region XYZ, that is Sunday, the rainfall was 30 millimeter. Monday, rainfall was 10 millimeter. Tuesday, rainfall was 7 millimeter. Wednesday, there was no rainfall, that means nil. Thursday, there was 9 millimeter of rainfall. Friday, there was about 5 millimeter of rainfall. And Saturday, there was 5 millimeter of rainfall. So if I want to find out the average rainfall throughout the week of a particular place, then how can I find it? Then what I have to do, I have to add all the observations that I have collected from the last week from a particular place, that is XYZ place. I have just given XYZ because it's just an example. So here 13 plus 10 plus 7 plus 0 plus 9 plus 5 plus 5 divided by total number of days or total number of observations. So total number of observations is how much? 7. How many observations we have done? How many days we have counted? 7. So it is like this. So 13 plus 10. So it is 23. 23 plus 7. It is 30. 30 plus 5 plus 5. 10. That is 40. 40 plus 9. 49. So it is 49 upon 7. So answer is 7. So 7 millimeter is an average rainfall of that particular place in a week. How it is denoted? It is denoted as a mean, but denotation is given by x bar. So x bar is equal to 7 millimeter. And what is x bar? X bar is a mean. X bar is what? X bar is mean. Then how this formula is given? The formula is given in this way. The formula is given like this. So x bar is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 plus x6 plus x7 divided by total number of observations 7. So here, if there are n number of observations, then how we will calculate? So we have given the formula for that one, that is x bar is equal to sigma xi upon n, where n is the total number of observations and sigma xi is the addition of all the observations, and x bar is mean. So this is the formula which is basically used to find out the average mean of a data. And if you see, this data is actually nothing but a random data which is considered as ungrouped data. This is considered as ungrouped data. So this method is, that is sigma xi upon n for finding out x bar, that is finding out mean, can be used very easily. So this method can be used for what? For the ungrouped data. But what about the group data? So let us talk about the group. Now before we go for the group data, let me read this thing for you. An average tends to lie centrally with the values of the variable arranged in an ascending order of at magnitude. So we call an average a measure of central tendency of the data. Mainly we are interested in three types of averages, that is mean, median and mode. Arithmetic mean, the average of number in arithmetic mean of these numbers in statistics. So there are three types of averages, mean, median and mode. And this is a type of average that is called mean, and it is for which data? Ungrouped data. So let us work it out for the group data now. So that one was for what? For the ungrouped data. So this one is for what? This one is for ungrouped data. And now what will be the formula for the group data? The formula for the group data. So first of all, we'll write group data. Now you must know what is the meaning of group data. Means what? It is a particular group is given. So 1 to 5, it is a group. 6 to 10, it is a group. 11 to 15 is a group. 16 to 20 is a group. So these are nothing but what? Class intervals. So for that group data, there are three methods for finding out mean. Number one, direct method. Number two, shortcut method. Number three, step deviation. Step deviation method. So we'll see first of all direct method. So what is the formula for the direct method? The formula for the direct method is x bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. So this is the formula for direct method. So we'll see the direct method first, and then we'll go to the shortcut method and step deviation. So let us talk about direct method. So this is the group. I hope you understood the meaning of group data. So this is related to our group data. So we'll see first of all direct method. So let us go to the direct method. So I'll explain, and then I will do one sum, and then we'll continue with the exercise. Then we'll see the shortcut method as well as the step deviation method. So first of all, group data. Which method we are continuing? We are doing direct method. What is the formula for direct method? X bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. So that means there are two things. Number one, you will be having class interval and frequency, and you have to find out xi, then you have to multiply fi xi, and then you have to put the formula x bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. That is the first one. Second one is it is in this one. Class marks are given fxi, then fi, and here fi xi. And what you have to do? You have to find out sigma fi. You have to find out sigma fi xi and put it into the formula. That is x bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. So this becomes really, really easy. Only thing is that you should know the all operational, mathematical operational things, that is addition, subtraction, division, multiplication and all these things. Then this is very easy, because this question is likely to be asked for 4 marks. Okay, anyway. So here, if suppose class interval is given to you like 1 to 6, 1 to 5, let us take 1 to 5, then 6 to 10, then 11 to 15, and if the frequency is given as 3, 5, 2, like that, if the frequency is given like this, then how will you find the xi then, because frequency is already given, xi is not given, then you have to find out xi. How will you find an xi? Xi can be found with the help of this one, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So in this case, 1 plus 5, 6 upon 2. 6 upon 2 is what? 6 upon 2 is 3. So 3. In this case, 6 plus 10 is what? 16. 16 upon 2. 16 upon 2 is what? 8. In this case, 11 plus 15 is 26. 26 upon 2. 26 upon 2 is what? 13. Then you multiply this one with this one. So you get what? 9. This one with this one. 5 8s are 40. And 13 2s are 26. You add. So here sigma FIXL is equal to what? 49. And then you have to go for 26. So we need to have a column to do addition work. So 49 plus 26. How much it comes up to? 75. So here you get what? 75. And what is the total of sigma Fi? Sigma Fi is what? 10. 8 plus 2, 10. So 75 upon 10. So that is what? 7.5. So 7.5 is our answer. 7.5 is our answer. So this is how we do the sum if we are having class interval. But suppose if we don't have class interval, then this is considered as what? Class marks. So if the class marks is 5, 6, 7, and here the frequency is given as what? The frequency is given as 4, 6, 2. Then this one multiplied by this one. So 5 fours are 20. 6, 6 are 36. 7, 2 are 14. If you add all these things, what you are going to get? You are going to get 6 plus 4, 10, 0, 1 carry, 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. And this one, what you are going to have? 6 and 6, so you are having 12. So after putting into the formula, we get 70 upon 12. If you divide 70 upon 12, so here 70 and here 12. Pi is 60 10.0 8 96. 4. So what is the answer? 5.8. So x bar is equal to 5.8 is the mean, is an average which you have found with the help of direct method. So I hope you understood this one. Let us work it out with one example. So I'm going to take one example from the textbook and then we'll start with the next method and then exercise. So let us take an example to find out the mean using direct method. So how to do this sum? So first of all, this is the question that might be given in your question paper, or this is the way they will be presenting you in the question paper, and your answer begins from here. So your answer states from here. Answer. So what you have to do? You have to write down first of all class interval. So what is the class interval there? Class interval. So class interval is 80 to 100, 100 to 120, 120 to 140, 140 to 160, and from 160 to 180. And frequency is given, that is our Fi. So what is our frequency given for 80 to 100? 20, 30, 20, 40, and 90. What we require here to find? We require to find Xi. And what is our Xi? Xi is class marks. So class marks means what? Lower limit plus upper limit divided by. So here 80 plus 100, 180, 180 divided by 2, that give me what? 90. That gives me 90. Then here same thing, so 110, here 130, here, so this one and this one you add, it becomes 300. 300 divided by 2, it is 150. This becomes 340, so it is 170. So this is how we find out the class marks. So lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2, that is our class marks Xi. Now what we require to do? Fi Xi. So we will find out Fi Xi, very simple. multiply these two, it is 1800. This one is 3300. This one is 2600. This one is 15 4s are 60, so 6000, and 17 9s are 153. So not 153, 153. So it is 1530, 153. Then if we add all this, we get what? Sigma Fi. So what is our sigma Fi? Sigma Fi is coming up to 50 60 110 110 90, so 200. And if you add all these things, what do you get? Sigma Fi Xi is equal to what? Is equal to 29000. So there are 3 zeros, that is 29,000. Now placing them in the formula, so I am not writing below, I will be writing here next. So let me get rid of this line so that you can see it properly. Okay, here. So our formula is, what is our formula? X bar is equal to sigma Fi Xi upon sigma Fi. What is sigma Fi Xi? It is 29,000, 29,000 upon 200. So what will be your answer? If you divide and see, you will be getting 145. So 145 is our answer. So isn't it simple? Just you require to have a knowledge of proper multiplication, addition and division, then only you can do it very easily. Even subtraction is also necessary, but still in this one you can find it. With these operations you can do it, this whole sum, for finding out the mean with the help of direct method. Okay, let's go to next example. That is where you are going to find out the frequency A and B. So that is one type of sum which is likely to be asked in board examination. The marks obtained by 40 students in a short assessment are given below, where A and B are two missing data. So you have to find out A and B. If the mean of distribution is 7.2, find the value of A and B. So this will be the presentation in your question paper, and this is how you do the sum in your answer sheet. So here, answer, first of all you will write down marks, that will be your Xi, because your class interval is not given, marks, and this will be number of students, that will be your Fi. So here we will write 5 6 7 8 and 9, and here you are having 6 A 16 13 and B. Then you have to find out sigma Fi Xi, and that will be here 36A, here it will be 112, here it will be 104, and here it will be 9B. So this is what we have obtained. Let me get rid of this extra line. Let me put it black so it becomes visible. Okay, this is what it looks like in your answer paper. So here your answer paper or the answer sheet should have Xi Fi sigma Fi Xi. Then this one I am writing here because I don't have space, so I will be writing sigma Fi is equal to 6 plus 16 plus 13. How much it comes up to? It comes up to what? 35 plus A plus B. So here it is already mentioned that there are how many students? Total 40 students are there. So 40 is equal to 35 plus A plus B. 35 goes this side, so it becomes minus. So 40 minus 35 is equal to A plus B. Therefore A plus B is equal to 5. So this is the equation that I obtained
by substituting the value of sigma fi as 40. Here we require this part, so let me change the color so it becomes identifiable. So here sigma fi xi is equal to what? It is, if you add 30 plus 112 plus 104, you get 246 plus 6a plus 9b. Got it? So here sigma fi xi is the addition of all those fi xi. So we got sigma fi xi, we have obtained the value of a plus b as 5 by substituting sigma fi, which is already mentioned as 40 students. Then mean, which is given to us, is how much? 7.2. 7.2 is the mean. I am not going down because I want to show the calculation here only. So here, what is the formula? So x bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. What is the value of x bar? X bar is equal to what? X bar is already given as 7.2. Sigma fi xi is how much? It is 246 plus 6a and 9b. That means 3 is common. So you get here 2a plus 3b, and total number of students is 40. I hope you understood this part. 3 is common between 6 and 9. 3 is common. So 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. So that is what I'm getting here. Now this 40 goes this side, it multiplies with 7.2. So 7.2 multiplied by 40 is equal to 246 plus 3 bracket 2a plus 3 2a plus 3b. Now 40 multiplied by 7.2 is 288. 246 goes this side, so it becomes minus. So minus 246 is equal to, and 3 goes down, so divided by 3, you get the value of 2a plus 3b. So now if you subtract this one from 8, 2 goes, it is from 8, 6 goes, it is 2. So here 42 upon 3 is equal to 2a plus 3b. Now 3 cancel and this one cancel. What we are getting here? We are getting 14. So what is the value of 2a plus 3b? 2a plus 3b, we got 14. So this is our next equation, or you can say second equation. This is our next, or you can say second equation. So this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. Now if your base related to 9th century is very clear, then the substitution becomes easy. So here substitution reaction will do. So here substitution reaction. Substitution reaction method for solving this equation. Not substitution reaction, but it is some sort of a reaction, because here we are going to get reactants and we are going to get products. So that's what it is. So here, anyway, let us go to the point. A plus b is equal to 5 and 2a plus 3b is equal to 14. So substitution method we are going to use. So here if we substitute the value of a as 5 minus b in the equation, in this equation we get 2 bracket 5 minus b plus 3b is equal to 14. Now here becomes 10 minus 2b plus 3b is equal to 14. Are you getting it? So our value that we are going to obtain here is what? 10 minus 2b plus 3b, that means it is b, is equal to 14 minus 10. We get the value of b is equal to what? The value of b is 4. So first value we got, the value of b we got, that is 4. Now placing the value here in b as in this equation, for p we get a is equal to 5 minus 4, so we got the value of a as 1. Hence we obtained the value of a and b. So value of a is what? 1, and value of b is what? 4. So you can say answer a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 4. So this is how we do the sum. I hope you understood the whole sum related to this finding out the frequency with the help of a direct method. Thanks very much guys, and I'll see you with the next sum with the different method, that is either shortcut or step deviation method. Thank you very much guys.